We are continuing on our tour of new features in Spring Boot 4, and today we're talking about the modularization of Spring Boot. So I've been doing a lot of videos on new features in Spring Boot 4, and one of the questions I've been asked the most is, hey, when I'm upgrading from a previous version like 3.5 to 4.0, I'm running into a couple of issues, and I want to talk about those today. The Spring Boot team has wanted to do this for a while, and they finally got their chance to go in and modularize some of Spring Boot. Now, where this comes in the past, so when Spring Boot started, there was a auto configuration jar that included all of the auto configuration you could possibly need. That jar was small, it was like 185 kilobytes at the time. Now that has ballooned into something like two megabytes or plus, like something in that neighborhood, right? So now we have this auto configuration jar that everything just kind of depends on. Well, the team went in and kind of split this out so that it's no longer this one jar that needs to ship with everything to auto-configure anything that you could possibly want when most of the time you're not using all of that, right? So this question came in the form of, I've had a few people ask me the same one. Hey, I was in a 3.5 app. I'm using an H2 in a web app with Spring Data JDBC or just JDBC, and I had the H2 console working, and now when I've upgraded to Spring Boot 4.0, that H2 console is not working. What the heck, Dan? What is going on? And so today I want to dive into why that's happening so we can understand how this works in Spring Boot 4 and even give you a way to kind of escape the way it's working now if you want to just migrate over to Spring Boot 4. So we're going to go ahead and jump over to my screen. I've put this diagram together and we're going to talk about how things work in Spring Boot 3 versus 4 and a little bit of an escape hatch if you need it. So we have our application here. We have a pom.xml or a build.gradle, and we went and picked some dependencies. And so we have some dependencies in there like Spring Boot Starter Web, Spring Boot Starter JDBC. And if we pick the H2 database from the Spring Initializer, that is a raw dependency in our pom.xml, right? What happens in 3.x is we depend on the Spring Boot auto configure jar. And so that is the auto configuration for everything. There's Kafka, there's security, there's MongoDB, there's Flyway, JPA, everything, right? Most of the time, we're not using all of those. So we don't need all of those. But in 3.x, we depended on all of those. And so this worked. And you can see down there, how does this work? Well, all the auto configuration lived in that one giant jar with JDBC, web, and H2, the raw dependency on your class path. We now have the H2 console endpoint was automatically enabled. No extra dependencies were needed. Because this big giant jar was here, something was on the class path, and then auto configuration kicked in. So that's how it worked. The way that it works now in Spring Boot 4 is we have our application. You see a dependency has changed here. We used to, if we picked web from the Spring Initializer, it would bring in the Spring Boot Starter Web. That was really for kind of web MVC stuff, but hey, we have these two different web technologies. We have web MVC and we have web flux. So now those starters are separated out. So we bring in Spring Boot Starter Web MVC. We bring in Spring Boot Starter JDBC. If all we do is try to flip the switch to 4.0, we still have this raw dependency problem, right? We have this H2 dependency in our POM. Because of this, we bring in things like Spring Boot Web MVC, we bring in Spring Boot JDBC, but we don't have something called the Spring Boot H2 console. That is not on the class path now. So why this breaks? The auto configuration code is now modular. You have the H2 dependency here, but the auto configuration code for the H2 console lives in a new dependency called Spring Boot H2 Console, which is not on your class path. So the quick fix for this problem is use Spring Boot Starter H2 Console, which pulls in both the H2 library and its auto configuration module. So we no longer need this raw dependency. Finally, if you want an escape hatch for this, in your application, you can add a new dependency called Spring Boot Auto Configure Classic. And that will basically make things work exactly as they did in 3.x. So you can use that to get all of the auto configuration modules at once, like the old giant jar behavior, and then start to migrate specific starters over to this. So I will go ahead and share this diagram out in the repository that we're going to build today. And hopefully that will help you out. Now, I'm also going to leave you with a couple of references here. I've been talking a lot about it on this channel because I think this is a wonderful resource. But the Road to GA blog series over on the Spring IO blog, there was a new blog post every week from September 9th leading up to the release of Spring Boot 4 talking about some of these different features. One of them in here is on the modularization of Spring Boot. And this was by the Spring Boot team. So go ahead and read through this if you want to learn a little bit more about that. Also in the Spring Boot 4 migration guide, there is a new modular design that now ships smaller focus modules rather than several large jars. So you can read through this, understand kind of the problem, take a look at the starters. You can see all of the starters in here. This will make things a little bit more clear. If you are migrating from 3.5 or 3.1 or whatever to 4.0 and you're having issues with dependencies or things not working as they were in your previous application, this is probably the first place that I would look. Okay, so I'm over at start.spring.io. I want to kind of play this scenario out. Let's say that we are in a 3.5 app. Let's just say dev.danvega, we'll call this our H2, and we're using JDK 25 here, and I'm going to pick a few dependencies. I'm going to pick the web, I'm going to pick JDBC support, and then I'm going to pick the H2 database. From there, I'm going to go ahead and download this. We'll open it up in IntelliJ, and we'll talk about the migration path for this specific scenario. All right, so I have this application here. I'm going to go into application.yaml, and I'm just going to say the H2 console is enabled. Yes, we'll call it true. That is the only thing we should be able to do to open up the H2 console. We aren't actually going to create a database and insert tables. We don't need to for this example, but I want to take a look at the POM, right? So we're using JDK 25 here. Here are those dependencies. So the old one was Spring Boot Starter Web. That will now be MVC. Spring Boot Starter JDBC stays the same. And you see we have that dependency on the H2 database here. So because we have the database on the class path and we've enabled the web console, right? Not even the enable part, right? Once that dependency is on the class path, we depend on that full auto configuration jar. And because the auto configuration for H2 console is in there, it will go ahead and kick in and make it available. So let's see if that plays out. Let's go ahead and run this. And then you see H2 console is available at /H2 console. And if we go there, we see the H2 console working, right? I don't even really need to test this out. I don't have a database for that, but the H2 console is available. So let's try and migrate this, probably the way that some people have been doing it. And all I wanna do is I wanna shift this to 4.0.0. We're going to reload this. And just to appease the starters, I will say that this is the web MVC starter coming from there. And I'll go ahead and reload this. So now I'm going to run my application. And we see, I don't even see anything in there about the H2 console being available, but let's head over to the browser and try it. And you see that that does not exist. That is no longer working, right? So if we go back to our drawing here, what we wanna do is we wanna include the Spring Boot H2 console dependency. So let's go back over here. We're gonna go ahead and stop this. I'm going to add a new dependency, Spring Boot H2 console. This comes from springframework.boot. Let's go ahead and save this. Let's go ahead and run our application. And we now see the H2 console is available at /H2 console. Let's run this. And there it is. So as we kind of point out in the documentation, there may be some scenarios where you come across this. If you're building a web app and you had like the REST client before, you need to make sure that, hey, when you're on start.spring.io, you got to pick an HTTP client, right? I'm not on 4. So if I go over to 4, I got to pick an HTTP client, right? And that'll bring in the appropriate starter for that. If you're using something like Flyway that got automatically configured before, you'll need to make sure you include the appropriate dependencies. So if this is something that you are dealing with when it comes to migrating from a previous version of Spring Boot to Spring Boot 4, this is the first place I'd look. Also, there's that escape hatch. If you want to include that auto configure classic dependency, it will work as it did before. And then you can go ahead and try to pick those off one by one. So I know I've gotten a lot of questions about this. I hope this helps answer that question. I learned a lot going through this. Thanks to the Spring team for helping me understand some of these things as well. And I hope you learned something new. If you did, you know what to do, friends. Leave me a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel. And as always, happy coding.